Hello, everyone. How is everybody doing? I hope everybody's staying safe and healthy. We are definitely living in unprecedented times right now with the whole COVID-19 thing taking over the globe. Seems like sports should be an afterthought, and I completely agree. Unfortunately, the NFL is in an offseason. So as of now, things are infected. There is talk going around though that, you know, sports in North America or in California might not be ready to go till November. Some people are saying that the season might be canceled altogether. I mean, you got to think about it as this, like this, is that they got to have a cure in order for anybody to ever be able to gather in a public place again. Because you can flatten the curve all the way and then, you know, you get 60,000 people in an arena or in a stadium and all of a sudden, you know, it ramps right back up and you do that all over the globe, all over the NFL and in a week by week basis and you could start this whole thing all over again. So the NFL right now, you know, they're going through their normal offseason as if nothing's being affected. The draft is being affected, though. There's talk that everything is going to be done, you know, remotely from their homes. People are going to be from their homes. I don't know if they're going to use something like Zoom or what, to keep all like the GMs and front office people intact. It's going to be an interesting draft when we watch it. It's not going to be like a normal, you know, guy running across the stage to chest bump and hug the commissioner. It's going to be a whole different thing. Personally, I'm actually okay with that because the draft to me, sometimes it becomes a little bit more, it becomes bigger than what it needs to be. You know, you got a lot of opinions sometimes from people that don't even watch film. They watch highlights and they think they have some knowledge on some player and, you know, like a Stephen A. Smith or, you know, guys like that. And, you know, it becomes too much analyzing. You become paralyzation from analyzation. So that's the one thing when you get into draft season that happens. And then honestly, just all the pomp and circumstances when you watch it, all the, you know, just it's going to be more streamlined. And I think it'll actually be, for me personally, be better for it. I don't care about all the other side stuff. I just want to know who we're picking and what I want to know about him. I want to know whatever scouting report they have and be done with it. You know, I'm trying to take this thing to sports, this video. I almost feel guilty making this. I'm probably going to get hate for it. But thinking about the 49ers offseason so far with the loss of Emmanuel Sanders and DeForest Buckner being traded, you know, the Niners are definitely a worse team right now. But they're still super talented. And this draft, to me, is important. You know, we've signed some depth pieces in free agency, but, you know, like I said in previous videos, this was going to be an offseason of really just re-signing and retaining and extending guys. The Niners just don't have the cap space to do anything much else. They're still saving cap space for the eventual long-term extension to Kittle, which to me, he should not take step on the field until he has a new contract, personally. Draft-wise, you know, there's a lot of discussion that the Niners are going to take a receiver at 13. I would love for them to take a receiver at 13, but this is a deep receiver draft. I would be okay personally if they took a corner at 13. Just because, you know, most of our secondary is going to be free agents after this season and you have to start looking towards the future. As far as, you know, especially with a guy like Richard Sherman, who's probably in his last year with the 49ers. Then you look at offensive tackle, Joe Staley's possible retirement looming. Still no word if he's coming back next year. So offensive tackle is definitely definitely a possibility at 13. I could see the 49ers possibly, if they had their eye on those three receivers and they're all gone, I could see them trading out of that pick, maybe a couple picks back to accumulate some draft capital. Like I said, it's a deep receiver class, so I mean they could grab a receiver just a couple picks later and then have other picks in other rounds. My hope is that they trade back from 31. If a team wants to come up and they think someone's going to be gone, they could, they could parlay that into some draft capital as well. I'm hoping that's really what happens. I have a feeling the Niners are banking on that too. It'd be interesting to see what the two tenders that they put on Kendrick Bourne and Matt Breida. Kendrick Bourne officially signed his tender. It's a second round tender. If they wanted to sign him, the Niners would get a second round tender if the Niners didn't match. Breida hasn't signed his contract yet, so that'll be an interesting thing, because the Niners have a really loaded backfield. And I trust Kyle Shanahan in the draft to find a running back in the 5th, 6th, 7th, undrafted. He's proven that he can find these gems in the running game. I mean, like, look at Raheem Mostert and guys like that. You never want to spend high on a running back anyway. So, you look at free agency. We didn't do a whole bunch. This draft, to me, is about just, I feel like increasing our depth is a very good thing because, defensive line, I feel like we can never have enough pass rushers. I mean, look at last year with all the injuries. And then you look forward with certain picks. You want to look forward because Joe Staley's retiring. It could be this offseason. It could be next offseason. And at corner. So those are the things I think the Niners are probably concentrating on. I think most fans who follow the 49ers that have any intelligence know that that's probably where they're going. The Niners have a good roster. The Niners are in a Super Bowl window right now. So it'll be definitely interesting to see what happens on draft day. I love the draft. I love draft season. I try not to listen to too much stuff because then I get like anxiety from it and then I get burned out. So I try to limit the amount of stuff I listen to about the draft. There is some silly talk going on Twitter. If you guys follow Grant Cohn, about the Niners, if they had opportunities to trade Garoppolo to this team and that team. And I see a lot of the criticisms that Grant Cohn has with Garoppolo, and I agree with a lot of them, but I don't want to give up on the guy yet. Give him another season, put more weapons around him. You either get better or you get worse. You don't stay the same in pro sports. So I hope the guy turns out to be the one. These Super Bowl windows don't last long, so if you waste it with a quarterback who's not going to get it done, it's going to suck. So, last year he was very inconsistent, and he had games where he played amazing, and then other games, like this New Orleans game, he was fantastic, and then you watch the last 7 minutes of the Super Bowl, and it's disappointing because you know what he's capable of. And then the defense was also to blame for that, too. It's not all on Jimmy. So it's an interesting topic to be discussed. It's off season, so people don't have much going on. And then with the whole COVID-19 pandemic, there's not a lot of sports. So people are just blowing Twitter and Instagram and Facebook up with all these theories and stuff because people have nothing else better to do. And it gets people talking, gives us something to do. I've been home since October with the shoulder problem. I had a minor surgery. So I've pretty much been in lockdown since then, so it's not a big deal to me. But right now it's all about trying to get better, stay healthy and safe, try to keep others healthy and safe, and hopefully we can all get this through this together. And I make a video like this because I just want to talk about sports and take my mind off of what's really going on. But in the end, this whole situation is bigger than sports, and we just need to get through it, and I'm praying for everybody. Hope everybody stays healthy. Hope everybody, just stays inside, doesn't go out, you know, keep your social distancing from people, and hopefully we can flatten the curve and get this thing over with sooner than later. All right, guys, I'll talk to everybody later, and everybody take care. See ya.